other day, and it took me back to my ILS days, you know, when I used to read a lot of doctrines, John Locke, Hume, Aristotle, Manu, lot of reading we used to do. Anyways, lawyers have no other work to do, so they either play or they read. Yeah, I used to do both. I used to read and play both, and of course I used to teach a lot of courses. In the sense, I used to travel and teach at that time. I still do. It has not stopped. But it came across with me with the Foucault. Michael Foucault is one of the scholars whom I had read extensively. A crazy guy, French fellow, crazy guy. So I thought, why not have a Facebook live session on his take? Back then, when I had read him, I was not able to sleep for another 2-3 days. A very extremist guy. Of course, his theory is considered very extreme. But then being the adventure loving fellow, I kind of loved his theory. I'll come online and I would share this story with everyone. Then I won't be able to reply to everybody now. Hi Komal. Yes, Isha. I was also waiting for my session, but then I found the interesting topic and here we go. So basically, Michael Fault, yes, Foucault, Fault, whatever you, however you spell him, it's actually a French word, so I'm not too good with French. So this fellow has written a lot of interesting doctrine about knowledge, yeah, knowledge and power. So the story, how I got inspired by his reading, yeah, the whole knowledge and the whole power thing was, I think I read him when I was 19, 20 years old, yeah, in my maybe the second or third year of my law. And at that time, you know, being a teenager, you're not really too much into a lot of deep knowledge kind of a thing, right? You just take things lightly. So when I read it for the first time, I was like, how can a person have so much of insight towards something? You understand what I'm saying? Yeah. See, having an opinion about something is one thing, and taking that opinion to the insight of it is something totally different. Yeah. So I was really amazed that, you know, everybody knows, right, what is knowledge, what is power, everybody knows, but a person who's actually deeply inside it is something which is crazy. So I'm not going to cover all his four doctrines. I'm only going to cover his one doctrine which I got inspired really well. Yeah, of course his other doctrines are a little more dangerous. Yes, his second doctrine deals about sexual identity. Yes, which I'm not too well versed about talking about it, but that's also something which is interesting. But I got interested with this doctrine called as so according to him, he says that power and knowledge, yeah, they are not two different things. It's exactly the same. Yeah. Now before I get into a doctrine, let me begin with a very interesting story. I think everybody loves, yeah. So the story goes like this: that there was one ship who was carrying a lot of goods, lot of things, yeah. And that ship, in the middle of the ocean, encountered some engine problem, and the captain was really worried. Now that ship had to reach at a certain place in a stipulated period of time. Else the entire shipment would have been lost. So that captain was really worried. He was strangled right in the middle of the ocean, didn't know what to do, how to go about it. So he told his entire crew to ensure that the engine is fixed within a span of 2 to 3 days. One day goes by, no result. 2 days go by, no result. 3, 4th day comes and none of the crew members on the ship are able to fix the problem. Captain is really worried. He doesn't know what to do. Finally, somebody comes to the captain and says, near the harbor, there is one old man who's an engineer, And he's pretty good with the submarines and the ship engines. The captain says, go, immediately go and fetch the guy. So the entire crew goes, he fetches the guy, the old man comes with a big toolkit, he inspects the whole engine, he takes one big instrument, he goes near the engine and puts a hammer on one part of the engine. Nothing happens. The old man says, wait, just hold on for a little while. Again he goes, and at the second place he again puts a hammer, and the third time when he puts the hammer, the engine starts, yeah, the whole ship starts running. Captain is really happy. He goes to the old man and he says, old man, thank you so much for fixing the engine. Now please tell me, how much do I pay you? So the old man says, the total cost of this fixing this engine is 5,000 euros. That captain goes on a, this thing, if 5,000 euros is like a lot of money. He says, the old man, it's a lot of money for a hammer. The old man says, the hammer, you know, the cost of putting the hammer is only 10 euros. 4,990 is the cost for knowing where exactly to put the hammer. Yeah. So he describes, he tells the captain, that it is not the action for which he demands the 5,000 euros. It is the knowledge where to put the hammer. The knowledge of knowing where exactly to have the engineering work done is where he's asking the money for. Yeah, I think we are all well versed with this point, that you know, in this particular time, in this digital era, it's not really the way you present things. It is more of how exactly you are knowledgeable in your presentation. Yeah. So coming back to this Michael Foucault's theory. Yeah. He simply says that if you want to be powerful, the only way to deal about it is having knowledge. Yeah. Many people have this concept that, you know, if you want to become powerful, you need to be resourceful. There should be a lot of people who come to you. There should be a lot of different aspects. But according to this scholar, Michael Foucault, he says that no. It's not the resources. It's not people. It's not. It's not nothing that really matters. What genuinely matters is knowledge is equal to power. Yeah. If you want to be powerful, you need to have knowledge. So that goes back to my thinking process, ki what exactly is power? You know, we say that, I want to become powerful. But honestly, what exactly is power? How will I say that whether a person is powerful? You know, it is very simple. What basically power is, you see, that's what I have something. That power is the capacity to make someone do something that you want. Yeah, what is power? Power is making somebody do something what you really want. Now it could be two ways. One is out of his consent, that I tell Nikita, yeah, that you know, do something. She will either do it out of her consent, or I will put a key to do something onto her. I will put some kind of a force. Yeah. Now when Nikita will do something after I tell her to do out of her consent, that is basically she is giving me an authority. Are you getting what I mean to say? Yeah, she is authorizing me to tell her something by which she wants to listen to whatever I say. So she is basically giving me a consent to have an authority. That is basically a power. Now in the second instance, if I put some kind of a dictatorship, or I put some kind of a force onto Vinit, no Vinit, you know, you have to do this, then that's not really an authority. That is a dictatorship. That's a training. Yeah. So power is something which is either out of consent or out of force. Now if you want to be powerful by which people give you consent, then you need knowledge. There are two ways about it. Yeah. And if you want to exhibit power by way of some kind of a force, then that's a different part of power which we are not really interested in, and that is dictatorship. Yeah. Knowledge brings power. The only way a person can be powerful is by being knowledgeable. You know, take a fantastic example of Stephen Hawking. You know, this guy was a completely paralyzed guy, that he couldn't even speak properly. Yeah, you know everyone about Stephen Hawking. If you not, then I insist everyone to read about it. The one who has written extensively about time. He was written extensively about black hole. This fellow is completely paralyzed. He can't even speak. He can't even move fingers. But then somebody like him can write a book called as Brief History of Time. Can have a lot of his theories on black hole. It is amazing. It's totally crazy. So power doesn't really mean by your physical things. It is completely to do with what knowledge you have. That is the reason why in this particular era, in the digital era, it is extremely important, no matter what profession you have, what age you are in, which country you are from, what race, caste, creed, religion, sex, it actually doesn't matter. What really matters is your thirst of gaining more and more knowledge. You know, this reminds me of one more very interesting story. So there are four friends. Yeah, three of the friends are very strong, very healthy, and very adventurous. Yeah, and fourth one is not so healthy or not so very physically fit, but he has a habit of reading a lot. You know, gaining a lot of knowledge. So four of them, they go inside a forest. Yeah, they go inside a forest. A big storm comes. In order to escape from the storm, they start running here and there, and eventually they lose track of the way. They don't know how to find the way. So everybody is extremely worried. Yeah, they know what to do. The fourth guy, who is not physically fit, he comes and says, "Don't worry about it. I know all the woods. You know, I know the forest really well. There's no doubt about it." So these three guys, they say, "All right, if you have the knowledge of the way, if you know how to have the way, we would like to follow you." So this weak guy, or I wouldn't say weak, but a really less built guy, he ensures that he follows the lead, and everybody follows him. They come out of the forest, and all are good. Yeah. Now, this is a very interesting story. You know, why this story is interesting is because the forest here, it represents the society. Yeah, where the people are stuck in, it represents the society. The three people, the well-built, the strong people, they represent the people whom usually we compare to. You know, we always tend to compare to people who are little above us. I mean, that's a valid comparison. There's no problem about it. But we tend to compare to people above us. We never see, you know, always have this. Just observe this. You never compare to people who are little below your skills. You always compare to people who are above skills. So these three people are the people whom we tend to compare to the outside world, who are physically fit, who show a lot of things. Yeah, but ultimately, it is the knowledgeable people to whom the world follows. See, whom would you like to follow to? Would you like to follow to somebody who is little fish, or would you like to follow to somebody who's intelligent? Obviously, the obvious answer to this is you would always want to follow to someone who's intelligent, who's wise, who's knowledgeable. Yeah. So, this world, if you really want to be successful, the success won't only depend on how well you are allocating your funds, how well you are talking to people, what kind of meetings you are doing, what kind of presentations are. Yes, that is 2%. The 98% of real success will come only and only if you gain knowledge. Be thirsty for knowledge. You know, Colonel Sanders, another brilliant examples which I keep giving. Yes, a bad product KFC, but good fellow Colonel Sanders. Yeah. This fellow started KFC when he was 65. Yes, he gained knowledge of making recipes at a very late age. I think after 45, when he had given up all the hopes, he actually started gaining a lot of knowledge. Yeah. So Ankit, I am going to come to your question in a little while. I will just finish up with my thing, and questions I will deal with little while. Yeah. So what point I want to establish is that the true power will come with knowledge. This true power can be in your personal life, in your professional life, in your day-to-day life, in talking to people, in having communication. All things will come only when you have the right attitude and the thirst for power, thirst for gaining knowledge. You know, take one example. You know, oh, today is Ram Navami. Happy Ram Navami to everyone. Yeah, you know, it is so interesting that amongst all villains which ever existed, yes, and amongst all the disciples of Lord Shiva, the highest of the most deadly villain and the highest of the highest of a knowledgeable person, the biggest knowledgeable person, is considered to be Ravan. You know, yeah, I was reading about Ravan today. Yeah, on Ram Navami, I was reading about Ravan. But you know, he was the most knowledgeable amongst all the asuras. He has sung on Shiva. You know, he has written something called as Ravan Samhita. Ravan Samhita is considered to be the highest book when it in terms of tantra. You know, he actually is the first one to create a BSF. You know, BSF is Border Security Force. You know, nowadays all the countries in the world have the BSF. There's a specialized branch of BSF in every country. Now, Ravan was the first one to have the idea of a BSF. You know, they will only and only guard the border, and it's a very different thing when it comes to army thing. This fellow, the Ravana, was knowledgeable in medicines. He has written the books on medicines, as he has done a lot of research on medicine. Everybody knows that Lanka was built out of gold. So basically, Ravan was a brainy. He was a super knowledgeable person. You know, actually, you know, they say that Ravana had 10 heads. It's not like that there were physically 10 heads which Ravana had. But he was master in 4 Shastras and 6 Vedas. You know, so 4 plus 6. 4 Shastras plus 6 Vedas. They all constitute to the 10 heads. So he had so much of intellect that his 10 heads actually represent that in one head, he had intellect equal to 10 heads. Yeah. So he had gained immense knowledge. He was a Brahmana. He worshipped Brahma, by which he gained knowledge. He worshipped Shiva, through which he also gained knowledge. But what happened was that knowledge gave him the power, which actually happens. It doesn't matter who the person is, whether it could be Ravan, it could be Ram, it could be of any caste, creed, religion. But if you have the thirst to gain knowledge, no matter what kind of a person you are, you could be even Osama bin Laden. Yes, Osama bin Laden was when it came to technology, he was a brilliant software engineer. Yeah. So when it comes to knowledge, do become powerful. But here the catch. Yes, the catch is what kind of knowledge that you gain. You know, the knowledge has three gunas. Huh? It is called as the trigun gyan, the three aspects of knowledge. It's very interesting. Just hear me out. The first thing is which is called as the tamasic knowledge. You know what tamasic knowledge? That you gain knowledge, but that knowledge has absolutely zero effects out of it. Like for example, gossiping. You know, not that you do not gain knowledge out of gossip. You do gain knowledge out of gossip. You understand ki kiske ghar pe kya ho raha hai, who is dating whom and all of that. But what exactly is the output of that knowledge? Zero. So that's a tamasic knowledge. Zero. Gossiping, you know, reading about something which actually makes no difference. That's completely a tamasic, so a dead knowledge which you don't do anything out of it. Yeah. Second is called as the rajasic knowledge. Yeah. So that kind of a knowledge which is actually used for demeaning someone or to destroy someone in order to put somebody down. Yes, it could be physically down, mentally, emotionally, whatever it could be. It could be to destroy someone. Yes, so that particular knowledge is called as the rajasic knowledge. Yes, that the characteristic is rajasic. And third kind of knowledge is actually the sattvic knowledge. Now this sattvic knowledge is something which is there for our higher ultimate. Yes, to understand It's not that these three knowledge will not give you power. Even the tamasic knowledge gives you power, rajasic knowledge gives you power, even the sattvic gives you power. But ultimately, what you do out of a power is dependent on how exactly which part of knowledge has given you what kind of power. Yes? The sattvic knowledge is something that can make you use of a power. See, nuclear bomb has a lot of power in it, but can you keep nuclear bomb at your place? Yes, can you keep near radioactive material? No, they are the most powerful things on the planet. You can't go near the radioactive materials. Why? Because the power that is generated out of this radioactive materials, it's not good for you. So, the bottom line of this entire thing is that whenever you are gaining knowledge, gain such knowledge that will put you into the sattvic realm of the power. Yes, sattvic means that positive realm, that good realm. Yes, actually there is no English translation of sattvicness. Yeah, sattvic is a Sanskrit word. Yes, which uplifts you, that which takes from one to the other. Like take another good example of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Yes. I consider him as the greatest ruler, greatest king so the entire world ever had, because he started from zero. Yeah? An army of thousands for against the army of tens of thousands. Yes, why? Because he had the thirst of knowledge. He gained knowledge from even the beggars to the people, to the normal, the common person, to everyone. Yes. Another good example is Lord Rama. You know, Lord Rama has, when he was a prince back then, he came to a point that, you know, I don't want to do anything. I just want to commit suicide. I'm just bored about life. Yes. Then came Vasishta. Yes. And then Vasishta gave him a lot of knowledge. This Prince Rama actually transformed when he got knowledge, and then that the Gita is called as Yoga Vasishta. Yeah, so understand that if you want to be powerful on all aspects of life, gain knowledge. You know, have more and more knowledge. Have more and more knowledge. You know, these days, yes, digital media is important. What is happening in and around it is important. But understand that gain knowledge is something which is very important. You know, my grandmother, you know, I will give you this brilliant thing. My grandmother, you know, she didn't even complete her fourth standard. You know, when back then my grandfather was the single doctor in those 30 villages. He is the only doctor who was operating the 30 villages, and he used to be on a constant, because there used to be a lot of people who couldn't come to his place because of their health. So he used to constantly travel amongst all the four places. So then the patients used to come, and they used to wait for hours and hours for him to return. So one fine day, my grandmother came to my grandfather and she said, "Ki, why don't you teach me with basic things?" So my grandfather says, "Ki, you know, it's medicine. You can't really teach it like that." She says, "Yeah, but whatever are the basics, you can just teach me." So my grandfather identified colors. You know, of course, I mean, now if she did that, she'll go behind. But I'm talking back then, the 1965-1966, you know, he identified color. So this white color paracetamol is for fever, this orange, this pink tonic is for cough. So basic things he started telling her. Now what happened was, she used to give people the medicines, and then came a point when she started taking a lot of interest in it. And my grandfather used to tell me, he's no more, he tells me, a point came when my grandmother used to give injections, not just that, she started doing deliveries. Yes, she used to, do deliveries for the women. Yeah. Now, a person who's not even fourth standard, back then she is only being inside the house, but that thirst for knowledge, a person who doesn't even used to read, she never used to write, doesn't even write, she had this she gained the knowledge and came to a point she could do the delivery, she could give injection. Yeah. So what I have realized in 32 years of my life is that if you really want to be powerful, wait for it. You know, power won't come just like that. You know, it's always a what do you call it as a short-term pain and a long-term gain. Yeah, if you want to be powerful on all the facets of life, have that little go through a small amount of pain, have that thirst of gaining knowledge, then only you will have a long-term gain. Yeah? So the whole Foucault's theory is what I am inspired with. Whatever I have observed in my life, I want really be powerful. If I want to do something good for the society, for myself, for my family, then I need to be powerful. And that power will come if I gain a lot of knowledge.